We're taking a look at the vintage collection of Lando Calrissian in his Skiff Guard outfit, which is a Walmart US exclusive at the moment. We haven't seen it listed anywhere else in the world. Thanks, Hasbro, make it available in only one store in the world. Really quite annoying. But thankfully, with great friends, I've managed to get a couple of these. So, looking at this figure, it is pretty damn good. Looks like they've used a bit of facial scan-ish, kind of, sort of. But a very good-looking figure indeed. Finally glad we've got this. So let's take the knife and cut this open. The reason I'm doing this, I normally open my stuff, but someone said this week they were a bit like disappointed that I didn't unbox things. Generally, I don't see the need to kind of waste your time while I do something, but then I have had people asking about how do I open some of these carded figures, so you're about to see. So your standard box cutter is what we're going to do here, and I'm just going to pierce a little hole in the bubble and then just gently tear around it. I don't know why I'm so gentle with these boxes. I'm not really going to keep them, but I kind of do for a while. I feel really guilty and bad when I throw away a vintage collection card. It's just like, it's kind of one of the key reasons to buy the thing in the first place. But there we go. We're getting a look at the figure. So opening up with a knife. There we go. Does that qualify as an unboxing, people? Does it? Kind of? I guess I had to have it in a box before I took it out, but there we go. So, ta-da! Doesn't really look as if I even cut it off the card. And you can just go, kind of, a little bit more. So, I figured it was very kind of hard to find at one point. Is it out? Is it not? What's going on? It finally came out. So here we go. And there's a little coffin. And just before we get a look at him, the card is beautiful. We really do get some nice detail there. Some people are annoyed at the other language being on the card. Deal with it. You live on a planet with tons of other people, so it's just the way it goes. But it doesn't bother me, but there you go. And we get age in different languages too, so 'tis the way of life. There's some text on the back if you want a freeze frame, and some of the other figures, all of which we have reviewed, apart from the Imperial Stormtrooper, who's brand new and is just about to come out, and Phasma, who is actually a reissue. But we'll get another look at her coming up soon. Right, on with this figure. Let's get on with it. So, out we go with the helmet and the weapon for Lando. I don't know why that's exciting for some, but there you go. Hope I got your rocks off. This figure is generally pretty good. I have to say, 3.75 inch, it's really giving me much of an interest back in this line. Definitely switched over heavy and hard to the 6-inch, but with figures as good as this, it's very nice to see such detail, and it's very tempting to go back. Now, kind of looking like a little bit like Billy Dee Williams and a little bit like maybe a star from a Bollywood movie, it's pretty good, I have to say. For that scale and that size, it's very impressive, so really pretty good. I don't know whether they genuinely have done any facial scan stuff there, but it kind of looks too good to be hand-painted, and it kind of has that material that they put on the lips when they're using the facial scan. It's almost a kind of programmed dot matrix of darker paint rather than hand-painted, so it does not look hand-painted. It does look kind of printed on, but we don't really know. Beautiful detail on the chest there with all the kind of dimples in the metallic kind of pieces there, which is also on his forearms of the gauntlet, and gorgeous kind of detail on even the tiny little studs around the shoulder pad there are really nice, and the back with a kind of ribbed effect, it's like wood on the back and cloth going on there too, little tramp stamp on his leg, but very nice, very nicely done, very kind of accurately done. Colors look good. Let's get the helmet on, which fits on pretty good and gives that just a little bit of Billy Dee's mustache poking through. And that looks good. That does look good. The helmet's really well done. Lovely colours on that. Got a little bit of the silver at the front there, which looks nice. Almost kind of coppery coloured. The bone looks good. You have that kind of tan material that's obviously off something's jaw. And the silver for the top of the kind of visor piece. Look at that. Lots of little nice details in there, like studs on the metal. This is a 3.75 inch figure. Very, very impressive. Do like this. Now the staff, the weapon, is pretty good as well. It's actually got a nice colour differential. The main body of the weapon is a kind of very charcoal-y grey. It might not show up too well, but this is actually a kind of muted silver down here, which is really nice. That's a nice, nice effect. And lots of detail on the... let me see if I can zoom in a little bit. Super zoom in. There we go. Check that out. Even the little cross piece there. All the little kind of ridges and stuff. Very nice. That is a very nice figure indeed. A very nice weapon, I should say. Lots of detail on it. And again, you're probably not seeing it too much, but it's genuinely very silvery on that edge piece. And that adds quite a nice bit of realism. Even this piece here, I know it's kind of a little hard to see, but this piece here actually looks to be in a different colour. I think it's just because it's so small, but it looks almost darker. Very hard to tell. I don't think it is, but it's nice. Nice job. So there's Lando, just another super duper close up. And that is very, again, 3.75 inch figures. That is a very impressive scale, size, and sculpt. What an excellent job, Hasbro. I have no issues or flaws about that except one, which is, hold on. He's got a holster but no weapon. Hello. What's going on there? There's no weapon in his holster. What the shit? Really? Hasbro? Are you kidding me? You gave us... What? What? What is going on here? Sorry, hold on a second. This is why I don't do unboxing videos, because normally I would have all this stuff down front. We've got a working holster there, but there is no blaster. Really? Why would that be? I think they made a boo-boo. I've got two here. Let me just triple check in the box, in the star case. There's no weapon in the holster. So, okay, let us know in the comments below. Did you get a weapon or did you not? Weapongate. Hashtag Weapongate. Hashtag Lando Weapon. What? Why would you do that? I'm sure I've got a spare one somewhere, something that is of that kind of ilk that I could use, but that's kind of annoying. Okay, why do we get such a great figure and then just something's not quite right? That doesn't seem right to me. There is no place, however, in the plastic tray for a weapon. It is staff only, so I smell a cost-cutting exercise there, but then that's just a bit naff. Need to raise that one to Hasbro. Anyway, let us know what you think of this. Articulation-wise, Lando is pretty basic, but very good. Let me zoom in just again a little bit more. The head is on a ball joint there, so you can kind of rotate any which way you like. There's no hinge as such. Arms the same as well. Pretty good. You can get them right tight and tucked under. Come on, camera. Right tight and tucked under the shoulders, which is quite nice. You get a single joint at the elbows. But it's a really good kind of angle, pretty good overall. And the wrists have the usual swivel. In fact, they're not any extra articulation. They're just a peg. Just a little plug going on in there. That's also unusual. Okay. We normally always get a little bit of back and forth action going on, but there's not one there. You get a swivel torso or swivel waist, I should say, and the legs underneath that flap, well, always about the flap, is a straight joint there overall. You get a joint at the knees, which is very generous, and rocking ankles, which is pretty good, and down to pretty reasonable little peg holes there for this figure. Okay, very with the blaster. That's a bit annoying, because he would have really worked with a great blaster, but maybe there's a reason why. We'll find out. Let us know in the comments, did you get a blaster? We'll be back with more reviews, but let us know what you think, and we'll see you for more reviews coming up. Cheers.